Hello everyone, till now we have seen so many subtopics in subtraction videos. Now we are going to see our word problems. As we have seen the addition word problems, now we are going to see the subtraction word problems. Now I am solving question number 3 from your textbook page 74. So in your textbook on page number 74, this is question number 3 which we are solving right now. So you remember the mantra for word problems? Rita finds dog so cute. So let us read the sum. Mr. Arvind and Mr. Srinivasan had to complete a 500 meter race within the given time. So they had to complete one 500 meter race within the given time. Some time was allotted. Who? Mr. Arvind and Mr. Srinivasan. Mr. Arvind finishes well in time, but Mr. Srinivasan covers only 416 meters. How many meters is he short of? So, Mr. Arvind finishes the race within time. But, what about Mr. Srinivasan? He has not completed full 500 meters in the given time. So, he has completed only 416 meters. So, what we have to do? What is asked? Find how many meters is he short of? Short of means how many meters he has not covered. What we have to do? Third step, decide. Addition or subtraction? We have to do subtraction. So let us start solving the fourth step. Now see given. First we write given. Given means the information which is already there in the sum. Now see the information. Distance of the race. What is the distance decided for the race? Is 500 meters. Distance covered by Mr. Srinivasan. What is the distance covered by Mr. Srinivasan? 416 meters. Why aren't we writing distance covered by Mr. Arvind? Because Arvind has finished the race within the given time. Distance to be completed by Mr. Srinivasan. Okay, or he is falling short of the distance. How much? What we are going to do? 500 minus 416. Have you got it? Now let us start solving the actual sum. So 500 minus 416. Children, earlier we have seen double borrow sums like this, if you remember. Now see here. Here is 0. We have to minus 6 from it. Can we? No. So we need to borrow 1 from here. When we think of borrowing 1 from the tens place, what do we have in tens place? In tens place also we have 0. So now we have to finally go to the hundreds place. So from hundreds place, first we are taking a 0 here. So this becomes 4 and this becomes 10. Correct? Now this 1 I am going to give to the ones place. Tens is become 10 now. Now I am going to give 1 tens here. So, this is going to be 9 and this is going to be 10. Okay. Or you can write like this also, that you can cut this 0 and you can write 10 over here. So, see there were 2 zeros here and we didn't have anything to borrow. So, we have jumped to the hundreds place to borrow. We have borrowed from hundreds place. 1 we have taken here and then the same 1 we have given here. That is why it becomes 9 in tens place and 10 in ones place. Now we can subtract. 10 minus 6 is 4. 9 minus 1 is 8. And 4 minus 4 is 0. So what is the distance which Mr. Srinivasan could not complete? Is 84 meters within the given time. Does our sum get over here? No. We have to write the final statement. So we write answer is equal to, thus Mr. Srinivasan could not complete 84 meters It is same as he was falling short of. Falling short of means he could not complete some part of the race, and that is 84 meters. Let us see the next sum. It is also from your textbook. Textbook page number 74. We are solving question number 8. I repeat, textbook page number 74, question number 8. Let us read the question first. Shyam has 478 stickers while Ram has 689 stickers. Who has more stickers and by how much? I think the problem is very simple. Shyam has some number of stickers while Ram has some number of stickers. Now, by looking at the figures 478 and 689, I think we would answer our first question. Who has more stickers? 478 is bigger or 689 is bigger? Obviously 689. Who has 689 stickers? Ram has. So who has more stickers? Ram has more stickers than Shyam. Now we will see the next part. And by how much? So we need to find out by how much Ram has more stickers than Shyam. Now when we want to find out by how much, we have to add or subtract. We have to subtract. Suppose I have 10 ice creams with me and my friend has 5 ice creams with her. So who has more? Obviously I have more. How many more I have? I have 5 more than her. How did we find out? I had 10. I have subtracted her ice creams, that is 5 ice creams, and I got my answer. Same way we are going to do here. Let us see the given part of our question. Number of stickers Shyam has 478. It is written in the question. Number of stickers Ram has is 689. Here it is given. We have to find out number of more stickers with Ram. So how many more stickers Ram is going to have? That we have to find out. So what we are going to do? 689 minus 478. Children, in the earlier sum, we had subtracted 500 and 416. Already 500 was on top and 416 was at the bottom. But here this is not the case. See, if it's an addition problem, we can write it anyhow. We can write 478 plus 689 or 689 plus 478. But in subtraction, you cannot change the order of the numbers. So, if you change the order of the numbers, yes, you will get a different answer, but that you will learn later on. Now, right now, we have to write the bigger number first and we have to subtract the smaller number from it. So 689 minus 478. Now let us solve. 689 minus 478. I think it is easy. 9 minus 8 is 1. 8 minus 7 is 1. 6 minus 4 is 2. It's a simple subtraction. No borrowing. So 211 stickers are more with Ram. So our answer is equal to, thus Ram has 211 more stickers than Shyam. And now our sum gets over. Let us see the next problem. That is on text page 89. I am solving question number 3. Let's read the sum first. There are 5675 workers in a factory. If 3759 of them are men, find the number of women workers. So, total number of workers or the workers in the factory who are working are 5675. Out of them, we know only the number of men workers. So, in the factory, there are men and women both are working. But we know the number of men workers. So, the number of men workers are 3759. Now, we need to find the number of women workers. So, what we have to do? We have to subtract. Okay, let us see given. Total number of workers in the factory. Total number of workers in the factory are 5,675. Then number of men workers in the factory. Number of men workers are 3,759. Now we need to find out number of women workers. So number of women workers is equal to 5,675 minus 3,759. Now we are going to solve the sum. Now see children, 5 and 9, can we subtract? No. So we need to borrow. We need to borrow from tens, and so the tens become 6, and here it is becoming 15. Now 15 minus 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. So it is 6. Now go to the tens please. 6 minus 5, yes, we can subtract, and it is 1. Now go to the hundreds place. 6 and 7. Can you subtract? No. So again you need to borrow here from the thousands side. So here thousands side becomes 4 and hundreds side becomes 16. Now 16 minus 7. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So total there are 9. There is 9. Now 4 minus 3 is 1. So 1916. How many women workers are there? 1916. So our answer is equal to, thus there are 1916 women workers in the factory. You can also write the statement as, thus 1916 are women workers. Anyhow you can write, okay? So here our sum gets over.